Welcome to the glass plate. In this example, we're going to take a look at forces on a band. Actually, it's not a band, it's a T. So what we have is a tube that has this shape. A liquid, say water, it's coming in at a velocity V at a pressure P through this opening, which I mark with 1. And it can leave at 2 identical exits that are opposite of each other, each having an area A. And the question is, what is the force acting from the fluid on the tube, or the T if you want? We know from the lecture how to do this. We need to set up a momentum balance, as the momentum balance has forces in it. But if we want to execute a momentum balance, we need to know the flows as well as the pressures. To find the flows, we can set up a mass balance, and to find the pressure, we can use a mechanical engineer balance. And we're going to do that and illustrate again how that works. And what we do is consider a steady state horizontal case, so this T junction is laying flat on, say, the table. And the incoming velocity is V1, whereas the pressure there is P1, and we're going to neglect friction. No friction. All right, so the first step is finding the velocities here. And for that, we set up a mass balance. But first, we can use that this is a symmetric case. There is no difference between exit 1, 2, and 3. So upfront, I know that in absolute sense, the two velocities will be the same. Not as a vector, of course. One goes up, the other one goes down in the drawing. And the same holds for the pressure. Their absolute values are the same. Okay, so my mass balance is the first that I'm going to consider. And that reads as 0 because of steady state equals in minus out plus a 0, as there is no production. There is only one in term, which is rho A V1, and there are two outflows, rho A V2 and rho A V3, which I can write as V2 because of the symmetry. So out of this, you quickly see that the outgoing velocity V2 equals V3 is half the incoming velocity V1, and I leave out the 1 and just call it V. Right, got that squared. So I know the velocities. I also, for the momentum balance later on, need the pressure. And I can find that from a mechanical energy balance, as there is no friction, hence no dissipation, and I do know the velocities. So this reads as incoming at position 1 is a flow, and that carries mechanical energy of these forms. And there are two outflows at 2, where I label everything with a subscript 2, a GZ2 plus a P2 over rho. It's water, so the density doesn't need a label. And there is a second outflow where everything is labeled 3. All right, first, these two are equal due to symmetry, or I computed that here, based also on symmetry, of course. If these are the same, then I can take these two together, and each of them is half what is coming in. So if we evaluate that, I'm going to get that 0 equals the incoming flow times half V1 squared plus GZ1 plus over 1 minus, these two can be added because the subscript 3 here can, for all terms, be turned into a 2. You have twice that one. M2, and now only stuff at exit 2 is needed. But this, let me try another color, is obviously equal to that one, as a mass balance term is basically what is spelled out here. So I can take out that one, and thus from the mechanical energy balance I have that this term equals that one, the two, because it's horizontal, Z1 and Z2 can be scratched out, and I can solve pretty quickly for P2. P2 equals P1 plus a half rho V1 squared minus, from this side, half rho V2 squared, which in itself is a quarter V1 squared, as I found from the mass balance. So P2 equals P1 plus a half rho times 3/4 of V1 squared. And note that this is bigger than P1. That may be surprising because we're used to flow going always down a pressure drop. But that's because we didn't relate that to friction. Then you need a pressure drop to have stuff flowing downstream. But that's not the case here. There is no friction. And what you see here is that the kinetic energy here and there is different. And thus, you change that over and you go to higher pressures. Actually, that's Bernoulli's law. All right. Having found that from a mechanical energy balance, all is left to do is equate what a momentum balance says, but I need two flavors for that. As now forces come into play, and these are vectors. So I draw my coordinate system, and I'm first going to look at momentum in the x direction. And I do that, I can better call this, let me grab a towel, the M of momentum rather than the I of impulse. But it's not the M of mass, it's the M of momentum. It's steady state, so zero is in minus out plus sum of forces. Sum of forces, that is to say, the X component. What is flowing in? That is rho AV as a mass flux, carrying with it concentration of momentum per unit mass of V, all in the x direction. This is the amount, this is the quantity concentration. What is flowing out? Well, there is stuff flowing out via convection, but it carries momentum in the y direction, and this is momentum in the x direction, so it gives a zero. Then I have the forces that I need to equate here. That is plus P times A at position 1, pressing in the positive direction from the outside world. Nothing here at these ends from the pressure, as it's again in the y direction. Plus, of course, a force from the tube to the fluid, its x component. And thus I find tube on fluid, x component, equaling everything to the other side, minus rho a v squared minus p a. And this is the negative via Newton 3, action is minus reaction, minus the force from the fluid on the tube and the x direction. So I solved half of this, and I should draw this with an arrow. All right, then next is the y momentum balance. Now I look in this direction. Steady state starts with a zero. What flows in from x momentum? Zero. What flows out, that is through exit 2 rho a v2 times v2, that is the concentration of y momentum at the exit, and there flows again, also such a term out through exits 3, rho A, V3 times, now I need to be careful, this is not V3, that is the magnitude of what comes out. But you see, this is actually a component of a vector, and thus this is magnitude v3 in the minus y direction, so this carry an additional minus. Then I need to equate sum of forces in the y direction, which equals p2a in the minus y direction, plus from the bottom p3a in the positive direction, plus of course a component from the tube on the fluid in the y direction. These two cancel. As from symmetry, these two pressures, in the absolute sense, the p's are the same. These two also cancel. V2 and V3 are equal, but this carries an additional minus sign. So we find that the force on the tube, from the tube on the fluid in the y direction equals zero, which is not a surprise because it's symmetric in the y direction. And thus, via Newton 3, fluid on tube in the y direction is zero. So our answer is this green line here. And this one can be added. You see, like the example we had in the video lecture, you use all three balances and you put in that there is no friction, stuff is horizontal, and there's a steady state, and then it's a stepwise approach, backing out from each of the balances one quantity more that you need to know before you can solve for the forces. Try variations from these yourself, and you will see that it's always the same drill. Good luck!